Gib mir das! Gib mir das! Gib mir das! Got it! Did I scare you? You might have noticed on a few of the posts, this guy in the background. I needed a new bag, and I bought this in Tennessee before I left Tennessee. Did it for two reasons, primarily. One was, you know, I'm real tired of spending like $50, $60 on bags, backpacks, that are really, you know, just unreliable and, you know, fall apart after, you know, 3 weeks of use or something like that. All the brand names, I've been through them all out here. And they're all crap. I have not found one I could rely on. So instead of spending like a lot of money on a bag that, you know, may not last 3 weeks, or maybe stolen, like, you know, in Tennessee, I went with the back to school special from Walmart. You know, just like mommy, you know. This cost me $16. All right. Now, if it falls apart in 3 weeks, fine. You know, would have a problem though if somebody snatches it from my hands and runs off into a project somewhere where they are never seen again. That could be a problem. But it seems to me like in 21 in Tennessee, the boys seem to be over the bag situation now. They're not obsessed with bags, shall we say, Mom? Yeah, so they're over the bag situation. Just complete hell there in Knoxville. Either at the shelter with the you know, they have a bag room there, you know, where, you know, they'll hold your bag overnight, you know. But so many problems with them. And just, you know, it's like, you know, you can't do this, you gotta do that. You gotta be here, you can't do that. You know, it's like, oh, man. So I've always kept the bag on me and to myself. And if I had to, I'd put it away in a locker at the Planet Fitness, you know? But, wow. The boys in the bags last year was just something. So I didn't want to waste a lot of money on another bag. And also, number two, I wanted another Batman bag. All right? Like the Batman that stole it from me in Knoxville. Just a sense of, eh, you know, all right, you took that, you know. I'll get another one. Ha ha, Batman. So that's why I bought it, you know. Just spite, you know, and just, you know, it's like, hey, I've been through a lot out here, you know, and I'm a survivor. Despite the bat boys and the Robins all over the country that have plagued me. So that was the second major reason I bought it. It's from Walmart, and it's a child's bag. It's for like grade school, middle school, I guess. Although, you know, you got 19, 20 year old boys wearing, you know, Superman onesies. Never mind. So, you know, but I don't think it'd be good here, say, on a, you know, on the University of Georgia campus. I don't think none of the boys, maybe the girls, would have a Batman bag like this. Probably go a little bit more collegiate. Anyways, this from Walmart, okay, for a child. And what's interesting, I didn't know what this was when I saw it on the display. It was displayed like this. See this? This, the bag was displayed, and I don't know, there's actually, I think, yeah, straps here. Where you can strap it. Yeah, okay. Yeah. It's for a child. You don't want them to lose it, I guess. All right. But they had, it was displayed like this. All right. And I could not figure out for the life of me what this was. You know? This I understood. I couldn't figure out what this was. This is your lunchbox. Is that cool? This is your lunchbox. So what you could do, so if they steal the bag, if Batman steals your bag, maybe you can keep your lunch. You know, we won't steal your lunch. I don't know, kids do that anymore? You know, like steal your lunch money, I think it would. No. They'd share. Oh, never mind. If they're not homeschooled, right? Yeah, Mom. So, yeah, this is a lunch box. Now, I use it, like, for papers and things like that to store, incidentals in. So I don't use it as a lunch box. But it makes a great accessory to the backpack because, this I can keep separate. And I don't need to have all the crap that's in the bag. And I could just store this in the larger bag. So, and all for $16, which I didn't think was a bad buy at all. And also a very telling buy, because 8 years ago, I bought a bag, a backpack, at a first store in Houston, I think it was. It was the first one, I think. And it was William. That's where William came up. It was embroidered, hand sewn. It was a regular bag, backpack. And I'll explain the difference in terms in a minute. But it was a beautiful bag. It was hand sewn. William's name was sewn, embroidered on the bag. And there was a Darth Vader sort of figure here that was sewn into the bag too. You could tell that, this boy's mother really put a lot of love into, his skull bag, And I found that very touching, very moving, for the bag. And besides, the price was right. So I bought it at the thrift store, Goodwill, I think, in Houston. And had it for years until it finally wore out. And I had to give it a burial. But William now resides in Memphis under the Poplar Bridge. Historic bridge, I'm going to add, too. Outside of Memphis, so. Anyways, that was a bag. Over the years, that bag has become a backpack, all right? From the numerous thefts I had of bags, of, things stolen from me, over the years, everything from bags to bifocal glasses, honestly, prescription bifocal glasses in Baltimore. Everything else was intact. They wanted prescription bifocal glasses. Well, But anyways, that love for the bag that I first had years ago has now become, you know, sad to say, a backpack, you know, with the bag on my back now, you know. And we could talk meaning of bags, too. I've had a lot of trouble over the years. Most recently, with the leasing girls in Knoxville over, you know, bags on my back. But hey, what can I say? You know, I don't live here. I don't have an apartment. I don't have a home. They do, so... So sad to say that love for the bag has turned into a thing of spite and a cynicism that has led me to buy this bag, this backpack that I wear on my back, around the country. For all the mothers and for all the love they have for their sons that keep America right and righteous. Have a good day. Have a nice day. Yeah! Yeah!